First impression of Xi'an.
Hey, why are you laughing, Jana?
It's just your dirty city again. But we're gonna find our way through. Just came out of the train station. Yes. That's how I would imagine a traditional city. So we arrived in Xi'an. The first attraction is actually the city wall, not the terracotta army. But we're gonna make it to there. It looks super dope. Yeah, we're gonna check it out more. Super cold right now. Behind me are all the high buildings. It's the new city of Xi'an. And here in front of me is the old city where the buildings have a limit on how tall they can be built. Reminds me of a city in Japan. We're about to witness a demonstration. What? Ah, they went away. Oh no. Let's follow them. There they are. So we had some Confucian temple and there's some cool statues. It's generally a lot of fun here in Xi'an. We're now headed to the Shaanxi History Museum, National History Museum. Shaanxi is the province here where Xi'an is in. I think it's bound to be interesting. Okay, so we finally made it out of this museum. It was pretty long, my legs hurt, and I'm super tired. And it was a little bit interesting because it was about Silk Road and history of Xi'an in general. It was okay, but I think we're going back now. I have no idea where we're going, but I'm tired. Let's just find out where we're going next.
Facebook.
YouTube. For those of you who wonder how a Chinese street looks like, I'm actually not impressed of that anymore, but for those of you who weren't here, like, they just don't know. Yeah, it's not like very clean, but the cool thing is these yellow bikes, they're kind of everywhere and you can just ride them for free actually, which is amazing. You just can go on that bike if you have the app and you can just scan the code. It's really easy, doesn't cost anything, it's amazing, but otherwise it's kind of dirty and it smells really bad. So as far as I know, we've made it to the Goose Pagoda, that building behind me. Yeah, let's get some shots. Ah, they just got wet from that stuff erupting. Seventh floor of the Wild Goose Pagoda. This is the view. Oh, perfect for putting a camera. What? Great. Beautiful. Nice. I noted with these Chinese Buddhist structures is that they are way more close to the Indian culture from the architecture. Like I am not sure if there's elephants here in China, in the south. Probably not. But in comparison to that, in Japan, the Buddhism was much more mixed with Shintoism. So that means here you have like more like real Asian feeling, that it's really like heartland. And Japan is really just Japan. It's just so special.
We're gonna go to dinner. And I think they're already discussing when to wake up tomorrow, because they're gonna get absolutely drunk. I'm not gonna join in this time, not for me. I wanna see Xi'an tomorrow. We're gonna go watch Terracotta Army, which I'm super excited about. That's why, yeah, I still have some stuff to do.
So welcome to the evening tour of Xi'an. This is the bell tower. We haven't seen it in the day. Actually, we've passed by, but it was so it was just like a traditional Chinese building, there's enough of that. But check this guy out right now. There's so much light, and also when we just look into the streets, you can see these things. These things during the day, they look like decoration, but actually they're street lights. Wow, looks amazing. Also these, check these out. This is just so illuminated. The actual goal is to get to the Muslim street, where there's like all kinds of Muslim food, which is quite special. I think there's like the Muslim minority is quite big here in Xi'an. So yeah, they have their own like city quarters and so on. Yes, picture. This guy takes pictures of me without end.